गाइस वेलकम बैक टू फूड एंड ट्रैवल विद फेस्टिव फॉर एवर। टुडे अगेन वी आर इन अंधेरी एक्सप्लोरिंग न्यूली ओपन रेस्टोरेंट कॉल्ड ऑस्टेरिया। नाउ ऑस्टेरिया इज एन इटालियन वर्ड। ओरिजिनली इट वॉज अ प्लेस सर्विंग वाइन एंड फूड। सो दिस रेस्टोरेंट मेजरली फोकसेस ऑन सर्विंग डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ एल्कोहल अलॉन्ग विद सम डिलिशियस फूड। Here you can expect Italian, continental and European food. Other than that, there is also a beer garden and most of the walls are painted in red color. Interesting, right? So let's go inside and explore some delicious food and some drinks. Let's go. Look at this restaurant, guys. It's so pretty. Look at the walls. So basically there were two sections, as I mentioned earlier, that they have a beer garden also. So I'm sitting at the beer garden because I thought it's more fresh and the weather is so good. I just thought I should prefer to sit outside. So basically their concept is to create a garden, and if you see that textured walls, and you know, some of the walls are painted in color, how you just, you know, get to see, or you know, usually when you visit a garden, it's more on the side of red and brick walls. So something like that is their concept, along with some flowery cushions and some flower pots, just to give you that feel. So if you're interested in beer, there are tap beers as well. Tap is kind of a fruit beer which is like from the tap. That's the whole concept. So if you're interested, you can call for those kind of beer and just sit in their beer garden. I didn't wanted to drink beer, so here I have my cocktail. There were various cocktails. They have two sections which are like classic cocktails and then modern cocktails, and I feel that their menu of alcohol is very, very versatile. Music that you can hear here is very, very loud, so if you are a music person, you're definitely going to love this place. Now let's begin my vlog with this cocktail called Watermelon Rost. Isn't it very obvious that it contains watermelon, but then the color is so watermelon-y? Okay, there is no such word called watermelon-y, but then still. So the color is red and they have added vodka in it, then orange juice, watermelon syrup, many ingredients. So let's go ahead and just drink this beautiful drink. Okay. It has a little bit of bubblegum taste, not exactly, probably because the watermelon syrup somewhere or to some extent does contain bubblegum taste. Other than that, vodka is very mild, which I really like. Sometimes vodka is so overpowering that I just hate it, but here it's very mild, and on the edge they have actually spread that, you know, salt, or just with the lemon and salt, that little bit taste is there. Lime juice is also there. Something worth enjoying. Now let's go ahead and try this coriander chicken. Along with my beautiful cocktail, I needed something, right? Something, some starter, obviously. So I would suggest, if you're coming here, you should more focus on your alcohol or your drink rather than starters or food. But of course, with your alcohol, you do get many choices. So this is called coriander chicken, और इसका जो smell है coriander का वो इतना strong है, it's literally getting into my nose. मतलब मैंने इसे दूर रखा था, I had kept it very far, but I could still smell it. I could still smell that strong flavor of coriander. Now let's go ahead. I think this would go really well with this drink. Very basic coriander leaves, mint leaves, and mint leaves kaisa wo minty minty taste hota hai na, waisa taste hai. Good amount of salt, and yeah, and I think ginger garlic paste, that's it. The preparation is very basic, but with alcohol I feel you're definitely going to enjoy this. Chicken is nice. It's more on the tender side. Oh, if you want to have a closer look, this chicken is actually little reddish, you know. So I think the chicken is very fresh, because I have heard that when your chicken is little on the reddish side, it's mostly very fresh. Now let's go to our next starter. Actually, it's not a starter, it's more like a snack or whatever you want to call it. These are tacos, basically veg tacos with the filling of cheese. Actually, I was expecting hard shell tacos because I am a fan of hard shell tacos, but nevertheless, we have here some delicious tacos in some different color of taco sheets, and then some coriander, onion, cheese, filling of kidney beans and stuff like that. So now let's just go ahead and eat it. So this is my second option after our coriander chicken. Little on the tangier side. Okay, these tacos are actually not tasting like tacos, it's more like a roti and sabzi for some reason, I don't know. But then you could have a different opinion, because in my eyes, tacos are supposed to or meant to be hard shell tacos, and if they are hard shell, then it qualifies for me. It has a little bit of sour taste, and the filling is okay. I think it's nice, it's basically nice. I don't think it's a wow dish, okay, frankly speaking, but then food is decent and good. Last dish that we have over here is called dandan noodles. So there is a choice. If you want in veg, you can call for it in veg, and if you want something to add on, then you can add chicken and egg, and I think prawns also. That I'm not sure of, you need to check the menu for that. So let's go ahead and check all the ingredients. So these are flat and somewhere sticky noodles along with vegetables. So basically, if you'll call it in veg, you won't get this egg and other, like you won't get this egg and chicken. All these vegetables will be there, that is the only difference. Like this is, I think, yellow bell pepper, some zucchini, some tomatoes, some onion. That's it. So that's the whole concept. Now let's go ahead and try it. It's a very good option. I think I would say that out of all the dishes that I called, I really like this one, then my coriander chicken and tacos. So basically, if I'll have to number it, I would say this dish comes on the number one, then coriander chicken, and then tacos. Somewhere, you know, matlab wo jo noodles hote hain, and you can taste the noodles along with little bit of soya sauce, oyster sauce, waisa taste hai. And obviously, and one more thing, isme na wo vegetables ka taste hota hai na, when you toss the vegetables in oil and along with noodles, so you can also taste that vegetables taste. So very good concept. I think they have also added somewhere garlic, but garlic ka taste kam hai, waisa to zyada hai nahi. But very beautiful dish, really loved it, and I think if I'm coming here, this is going to be my preferred dish along with my alcohol. First I thought I'll call for coriander chicken, but not after eating this. I think I would go for this. I was not really inclined to order dessert because I was already full with a lot of things that I had. But then these people were so nice and kind, they actually gave me a complimentary dessert which looked really pretty, okay. I have to admit that this is very, very pretty, and plus it's complimentary, what else do you want? So this dessert is called passion fruit panna cotta. So I guess it's made from passion fruit, which is very obvious. It has a very good texture, more on the milkier side. It's more like a custard, you know. Passion fruit taste is so evident, and it has a very creamy texture and very sour taste, very fruity, you know. The moment you have it, it's very fruity, that's for sure. I'm really going to say something very bizarre, and you guys might agree and might not agree. Have you ever had Shrikhand? So it's very similar to that, of course, with the taste of passion fruit. But then वो जो श्रीखंड का taste होता है ना, मुझे पता नहीं for some reason वैसा taste आ रहा है, along with passion fruit, of course. Milky texture, very creamy, loved it. But yeah, if you are somebody who enjoys श्रीखंड a lot, then this is your dessert, 100% sure. मस्त है. So guys, now it's time to rate this place on my festive meter. I really like this restaurant or place called Osteria. Very beautiful, and especially their beer garden. I would definitely suggest you to sit outside, but of course if you're coming here in summer, then you have to sit inside. If you have seen or you saw my earlier snaps, so you'll see that that inside place is more on the darker side. Like if somebody who enjoys more of darker place, then 100% sit inside. But if you're somebody who likes to sit, you know, all sunny and beautiful bright, then of course you have to sit outside. The place is it's they have a good choices in alcohol or different kinds of beer. So if you're somebody who enjoys beer, then definitely come here. I had a pretty good experience, and I feel if you're coming here, come with your friends, you'll enjoy more. It's not like a family place, mostly because I'm saying that the music is way too loud, and I don't think so. If you're coming for a family dinner or lunch, we enjoy that loud, so you know, that level of loud music. The alcohol is good, the place is good, the beer garden is good, their ambience is good. I think it's a win-win place. So I'm gonna rate this place 8 out of 10 on my festive meter. Do come here, visit this place, and if you visit this place, don't forget to tag me on my Instagram, that is festiveforever4. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Also, do tell your friends, family and share it to everyone. That will help my channel to grow. So guys, that's all for today. I'm gonna see you in my next vlog. Till then, live life festive style. Bye bye.